Television. Now, we are actually to be blamed, no? Mamaya meron akong sa inyo yung reference of this one. But look at this. All of these are, we know. But patient side, lack of knowledge and motivation, and perhaps not presenting to a physician, the poor adherence to medication, and the cultural and social factors. I think we have to address this because in the States, DTC or direct-to-consumer advertising is allowed. If you are in the States, pwede ka mag-commercial. In this country, those without therapeutic claims, sila ang pwede. Tayo, not even concepts, we cannot advertise. So in a country like ours, sabi ko nga ay, when I'm speaking, let's say, sa radio, nag-uusap kami ni Anthony Taberna or ni Jerry Bob, kahit ng BB1, and the spine is about 40 million, na maos ka na si in one patient. One patient, one car. Hindi mo pa na, but when you open the mic, in a 40 million Filipinos, nakikinig sa'yo, makes a lot of difference. So what I'm saying is that, perhaps you should go out and explain more to the Rotary. Kasi there's a lot of clutter right now na nakikita mo in the air. I'm not sure whether you're trying to get my point right now. Perhaps we have to empower ourselves. Or perhaps we should multiply in the first place. Because there's a lot of clutter in terms of information regarding health. Look at this. This is a survey in Europe. And I'm disturbed because the number one reason and barrier is actually the lack of time allocated by physicians to a patient. And samantala, pagka ang patient, dikit na dikit sa'yo, actually magnet yun. Mag-iumpisa ka lang na maaga in order to see the patient. But patients would love you to make time pay for them. Cost is an important thing for them and patient compliance. All the rest of them, guidelines, awareness, all of these are basically easy. But the number one problem is the lack of time. And the global burden, international and local, hindi nagbabago. Alright. Now, I disclose, no? Kasi wala nang ibang pwede sa inyo ipakita sa inyo about this particular relationship. And only this slide, so I don't have to reinvent. So the teaching process right now, iba. Let's talk about the patient, ang main customer natin. So nasa restaurant ka, French restaurant, o sa turo-turo tayo, recipe. Diba, we want to delight the customer. Tama ba? So let's talk about delighting the customer right now. And the most important patient right now is the country right now. In general, because we are facing the most challenging healthcare issue in modern times, with little budget, with migration of the doctors and healthcare professionals. Do you see that? Alright. So therefore, as a physician, ang daming problema. I've been using this for the HERO program. Look at this. PhilHealth, 50%. In other countries, 100%. Delivery system, fake drugs, access to the doctors. Hindi na tayo makikialam na. What we can do right now is actually preventive health education. Now, I came across this particular journal in Europe. They're actually advocating patient empowerment leading to efficient health outcomes. Ang definition based on the WHO is as a process through which people gain greater control over decisions and actions affecting their health. So basically, it's an empowerment of the patient. And there are six important factors. We have to know what conditions na kailangan natin i-empower. And most are chronic conditions. So, may patient ka, may diabetes and hypertension. These are the subset of patients that you have to educate. Not yung mga acute mga infection, kung given a short period of time. Because the mortality is higher in chronic diseases. Barriers, empowerment, and basically these are actually communication. Sometimes I'm not going to explain as a physician. Ewan ko, for some reasons, we are afraid to talk about this and we can't ignore the patient. In this time of age, so konti lang ang naka-electronic medical records. Sometimes, ang bilis sana, no? But you know, we have a problem like this. And then the health literacy. Environment. This is very important right now. We patients' right to choose and a menu of choices that is consistent with the patient's needs. This is actually yung pinaglalaban ng Philippine Medical Center at DCP. Because with this particular bill right now, the right of choice is basically not ours, not even the patient. So if the education is low sa mga pasyente, then we have a problem right now. And we need more than the usual. In modern times, sabi nila, I have an uncle, a doctor in the 60s. God, ang authority. But right now, hindi pa pwede. We need to partner with our patient. And we should put the patient right now at the center of the care process rather than the disease. And I think pag nasa ICU ka, you remember the bed and the disease of the patient rather than the patient. I think that's a normal perception and behavior of the physician. And then equity. How can you actually have equity? Let's say in the States, lahat sila educated, no? From grade school hanggang high school. In our country, ilan na nakakatapos ng kolehiyo? And not even the health education is actually integrated into the curriculum. So we have a problem in terms of equity, particularly the lower socioeconomic strata. And how about motivation? Now, let's now go to the physician. I have one important slide to show you, aside from this one, that a physician should be a healer, an educator, an advocate, a leader, healer, hero. And this is basically your health. I think more than ever, talagang it's sabi nga ni Nenon kanina from the airport, very important ang role of physician right now. Healing, educating, healer, healer, and saving lives. I think in every heart, there's an altruistic behavior and attitude for all of us to save it. Not just for the money, but more than ever, we need to be advocate right now in this very challenging time. Now, I'd like to show you one particular global study. What are the doctors really thinking? Their perceptions and attitudes of the medical profession. This was initiated by Pfizer in 2004 to understand the needs and expectations and issues of the doctors as public servants and perspective of doctors. So basically, it's an ongoing one. And these are some of the questions asked, the doctor's position on key issues, how satisfied doctors, what to expect in the next 10 years, what are they saying right now in their clinical practice, what would have a positive impact on their patients and then their practice, and what particular case the doctor want in the next 5 or 10 years. So just to summarize,